Helen Gallagher has received rave notices for her portrayal of the actress. TALLULAH, the musical, is playing at the West Side Arts Theater. Before we talk to Helen, here's a clip from the show. Welcome you to Live at Five. Now, I must say my memories of TALLULAH Bankhead are mostly as a talk show guest on Jack Parr and Lifeboat. But I always remembered her as being so funny, but I always had the feeling I didn't want to be on her bad side. You know?
No, I don't think she'd be a person. It would be good to be on her bad
did
side.
Did you have any history with her before you did the play? Did you ever know her?
I only shared a dressing room with her one night at the City Center. She was doing, I believe, that time, Streetcar Named Desire. I saw her in that. She was quite phenomenal in that part.
I thought she turned that down.
She did turn it down. The original was, she did the version they did at the City Center with her own company, which was notoriously bad, the company, but she was brilliant in the role. And I shared a dressing room. We were doing a benefit for the City Center. And I have never met a more nervous woman in my life. She was going, no, darling. I mean, what are we going on, darling? I mean, are they really going to tell me? And I kept thinking, I was about 26 at the time. And I thought, if she's this nervous, how nervous should I be?
Really?
I mean, because I wasn't all that nervous. Well, I was a good deal older than 26. Helen, stop lying. Now that I think about it, what I was old, but I still should.
But a star of her magnitude, you were surprised.
Absolutely. I couldn't believe how nervous she was. She was trembling.
Well, they say in this play that that you pay more attention to her personal life, her sagas with her husbands, et cetera, her outrageous sense of humor, as opposed to the career. Why was that? Why did
it, well, because it was her persona that interested people. Mm-hmm. It did at the time when she was on this planet, and it seems to now that she's passed on. Though she hasn't completely passed on, because I believe that she enters my performance sometimes. I mean, she saves me from things happening. The other day, I was standing on stage, and someone would just cackled, and I looked at her and I said, "Darling, that's tomorrow." And that's TALLULAH.
Do you have some favorite lines in the scene? Because she was so cutting at times that I imagine there are some great lines.
Oh, unbelievable lines. There's one I love when she says, a certain journalistic type once compared me to Ravel's bolero. She said I didn't develop. I just got louder and louder. I love that line.
They say that she made some wrong career decisions.
To say the least.
Yes.
I can empathize with that. Well, she turned down Streetcar Named Desire. She turned down Sweet Bird of Youth. I think she turned down Streetcar for, I'm trying to think about it. She did The Eagle Has Two Heads and fired Marlon Brando as her leading man.
Oh, dear.
She took Die, Die, My Darling instead of Baby Jane. I mean, it just was infinite. Well, of course, you know, you could compare any career, and we all make bad decisions.
What did you turn down? Because you looked pained.
I turned down Hollywood to do a show called Hazel Flag, and that ended my first career.
So you can never
fortunately, I went on, but I think this may be my third career now.
This play, does it make TALLULAH out to be a sort of a down, pathetic character?
No, not at all. In the end, you do, I mean, she had a very special relationship with her father, and it was never really one. She was the kind of person that even enough wasn't enough for her. And so he was a kind of withdrawn man, though he adored her, so the stories go. But he was just not there for her, the degree that she needed it. Of course, I'm not sure that anybody could have been. She needed so much. She was a needy lady.
It would be hard to know also if she needed, because she had a lot of bluster, is that so?
Yes, a lot of, you know, bizarre. She says, that's the way it is, and that's the way it's going to be. And she's very honest and totally against any form of hypocrisy. And outrageous. Way ahead of her time. Way ahead of her time.
I think even now some of her comments.
When they were doing that little thing about Katie Hepburn, I was thinking, well, TALLULAH was of the same kind. Mm-hmm. She led her life as she chose to lead it. She was quite a bit self-destructive, but she had everything, beauty, name, power, luck, talent. And she seemed to, in a lot of people's eyes, throw that away. But what she had was a great zest for living.
Well, Helen, we want to thank you.
Silk Stockings is approved by the National Education Association.
You're too intelligent not to see it. Now, here we have the leading Soviet composer, Borov, lending his art to a Peggy Dayton picture which will circle the globe in cinemascope. Just think, the Iron Curtain dissolved by music. Why, it's absolutely sensational. What a gesture of goodwill on the part of the Russians. And what propaganda.
Oh, propaganda.
Propaganda.
Ah.
Well, of course, you three will have to stay here and supervise and help. Why, you'll become national heroes.
Comrade Bibinski, he has a very strong point.
Propaganda.
Da, 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 da.
Bibi, this may mean the order of Lenin for you.
You can't throw away this opportunity for greatness.
Can we throw away this opportunity for greatness?
Comrades, perhaps we should stay here for a while.
We got to sacrifice our own feelings for the good of the party. I go and register.
There's no need to. I've already made a reservation for you. The Royal Suite.
Royal?
Royal.
You deserve the best. Furthermore, while you're in it, it will be called the Workers' Suite.
Oh, then we stay!
Too bad. But for the sake of Russia.
Can't go back to Moscow. Do pity us, do. Instead of writing symphonies to Russia divine.
At home, oh yes, you write them, you're sent off to a mine.
We'll hear you at the Ritz bar singing Sweet Adeline. Too bad. Instead of counting chickens on each farm everywhere.
In case the party member has a chicken to spare.
We'll see you counting chickens at the Folies Bergères. Too bad.
Bah!
Too bad.